Hey there, welcome to the 68th episode of Under the Radar. I'm stoked to be back. I'm in travel mode right now, just popping up in different locations here, hanging out at a buddy's place here in North Carolina while I'm playing some gigs. But I'm going to make this episode today very short. I don't have a lot to say about Slave to Servant or anything. I'm sure in the next coming episodes I will talk more about what I'm working on with the red tape and videos and things like that. But in short, feel free to support me and go to slavetoservant.com/store and purchase any merch. Also, samswansonmusic.com/store is a great place to go as well. So in the last episode, I covered a band called Unique Chic for the second time. And today, the band that I'm going to be covering, I briefly talked about in one episode, the Thick Records, Various Artists, Thick Hair compilation. And they had a song on there called The Greatest Betrayal, which is actually a demo version of the opening track to the record that I'm going to be covering by this band today. This band is a punk rock band from the suburbs. I believe they were from Berwyn, Illinois. A band called Much the Same. Now, this band, I think, deserves a little more attention, especially their previous full length that came out in 2003 was kind of a heavy hitter in our scene at the time. The band started off on AF Records, which is Anti-Flag's label. They were touring a lot with them and Suicide Machines, bands like that. Dan Precision, or Mr. Precision, who I've mentioned in previous episodes, Rise Against, obviously was the guitarist for them, and he recorded their original material on their debut film, full length. But this record here, I feel like kind of this one got a little slept on at the moment. It was a time when emo or commercial arena rock emo held sway and eyeliner was a thing, and this band kept it real and did a full-length album with Cameron Webb, who, if you don't know who Cameron Webb is, he's done everybody from Lit to Motorhead to Godsmack to 311 and Offspring, for criminy's sake. He's very well known for being a guy who mixes, but he also does producing and recording as well. And this record was done all by Cameron, and it sounds amazing. So this was dropped in 2006, and the band was signed to Nitro Records, which is another great label that I don't think I've ever covered in this series yet. Dexter Holland from the band The Offspring, he started this label, and I believe the first thing he ever put out on the label, I may be wrong about this, but was like the original Offspring full length before Ignition. He re-released it after the band had, it was like in part with Nitro and Epitaph, and there was a song on it, sorry for nerding out right now, but there was a song called Kill the President, and it got cut eventually from the track listing. So I have an original Nitro Records / Epitaph pressing on CD of that. You can't get that, I don't think, anymore. It got banned for that. Not very punk rock to cut that from the track list, by the way. Anyhow, I'm digressing. Point being is that Nitro Records went on to put out bands like AFI, probably one of the most notable. Put out The Vandals, Guttermouth, a lot of punk rock bands in the 90s, and they had these compilations like Go Ahead Punk, Make My Day, and Deep Thoughts, and I remember those were just, I think I've talked about comps a lot in this series so far, and that those were like our Spotify playlists, you know, and so comps were incredibly valuable to me as a teenager, and Nitro's comps were pretty amazing. So going on, around the time that Much the Same dropped this record, I would say that Nitro was kind of phasing out. I think they were only around for another year after this, before getting acquired later by a major label. Bicycle Records did acquire them, and by extension of that, now Nitro's catalog is, I think, owned by Universal. So anything that I play off of this today will surely get banned, or, you know, just know that it'll probably not get shown to a lot of people. But I felt the need to showcase these songs. Now, before I get into the songs, I want to describe the style of Much the Same. Much the Same kind of stuck to a more skate punk style. I would say it was very in line with bands like 10 Foot Pole and Pennywise, stuff like that. I mean, there's some face to face there, but it was very fast, a lot of it, and they just did it really well. So, like 88 Fingers Louie, definite influence there. I think I've also mentioned that they shared a member. I think the drummer, before the band signed to Nitro, the drummer left and joined the band First Class, which I've covered in the past. We, being Midwest Blue, we played with Much the Same one time at the Warp Skate Park in Woodstock, Illinois. And Gunner also was known for kind of being an outspoken Christian, and that wasn't a very common thing in the scene, but Gunner was a really nice guy. And later on, after Much the Same disbanded, Gunner, I believe, became part of the choir at Willow Creek Church. So that's a little history on that tip. Anyway, let's just go ahead and break into this release. We'll just go ahead and go straight for the jugular and give you the full Much the Same sound here with a song called Living a Lie.
It's a shame to think you have to live this way. It's a shame I should never have known. You travel so far and you have so much power. If only you would let the million show. It's a shame.
In a nutshell, is very, I think, representative of Much the Same and their style. Very fast, melodic punk rock, and while there is definitely some variety on this record, that captures, I think, the band very well, that song. The next song, I really enjoy the verses on this, especially because they stayed clean and very melodic. This song is called Gutshot.
Photographs that hang on my wall meant everything. Looking back, they all seem like a fading dream. But waking now, I know that it's just a fallacy. I rub my eyes and face reality. How could I just sit and ignore the signs? Was it easier to say it was fine? Now the words are out in the open air. Try to make it right, but you don't care.
Is also a little bit more, I think, representative, like the first song I played, of the band's signature style. This song is called What I Know.
Can you be sure? I don't plan you out being
song. That I think that one might be my favorite on the record. It just has a nice hook to it and really brings me back to like Unwritten Law and 10 Foot Pole, what I was listening to in like 98, 97, 98. Just kind of brings back that energy. I'm only going to play one more song off of this record, and this final song really showcases more of more variety. It's a little bit slower, and it's quite melodic as well. This song is called For Those Left Behind. Song, great record. Survive is definitely one I think you can still stream on platforms, given that Universal owns it, right? But I also found, I wanted to mention that the band has, much the same, has a Bandcamp page, which I always try to plug the Bandcamps these days. They have this record available. Also, there was a bonus track that didn't make the record. The song is called Seasons Change, and it features Nick from the band The Swellers, another band, I believe they were from Michigan. They were kind of always touring through Chicago, and I remember getting some of their early records as well. But it features Nick on that song. Never saw the light of day unless you got the Japanese version of this record. So very cool that they have it up on Bandcamp here where you can download it. I'm sure if you go on Discogs, you may be able to find an actual CD. I don't know if this was ever pressed on vinyl or not. I should have probably done my research on that. I also wanted to mention that Gunner, the singer, did backups on Break the Silence's Near Life Experience album released by Hopeless Records, which I think I've talked about in the past a little bit. But he did backups on that record. He did backups on a few different Anti-Flag records, which is amazing. So Gunner himself, and much the same, I feel like the contributions of he and his band in the Chicago scene and just the national scene was quite impactful, and wanted to make sure that I would give them a shout out today. And also forgot to mention, this is a little bit of nerdery for me, but in reference to Cameron Webb, who mixed and recorded this record, he also mixed one of my favorite, I guess you'd say it, early emo records, a band called Park, but it was on Lobster Records, and phenomenal record, worth mentioning if you like the early kind of semi-mathy Braid, Hey Mercedes stuff like I'm a sucker for. So check out Park, and go to Bandcamp and support Much the Same. Get some of their records, find out what else they're involved in these days. And in other news, I'm just staying busy, getting ready to go from North Carolina to the Ozarks for a while, and then I'll be heading to New York and enjoying a bunch of gigs. Yeah, I don't really have too much for you at the moment. I plan on dropping a couple more episodes on some hip-hop groups, actually, that I really dug from Chicago and had played with previously. And so I'll be working on those in the pipeline here. But just want to say, you know, I appreciate you for just checking out the channel. Please feel free to go to slavetoservant.com/store and support me, as I am a full-time musician and I have quite an abundance and overstock of merchandise in my store. Shirts, posters, CDs, vinyl, stickers, all of that stuff. Feel free. Yeah, so I'll be seeing you soon, and thank you for your time.